गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल, सिट इन सुखासन, हैंड्स रेस्टिंग ऑन द नीज इन ज्ञान मुद्रा और चिन मुद्रा, सिट एरेक्ट, क्लोज योर आईज, स्टार्ट प्रेयर. असतो मा सद्गमया, तमशो मा ज्योतिर्गमया, मृत्योर्मा अमृतंगमया. ओम सहनाववतु, सहनो भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै, तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु, मा विद्विषावहै. ॐ शांति 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 शांति. हरिः ॐ तत्सत्. ॐ नमः.
लेट अस मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट पोस्चर, उत्तान पादासन. इट्स आल्सो कॉल्ड रेज्ड लेग पोस्चर. लेट अस सी द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ दिस रेज्ड लेग पोस्चर. इट रिड्यूसेस द फैट इन द एरियाज ऑफ हिप्स, थाइस एंड टॉर्सो. It cures all the diseases pertaining to urinary system, piles and fistula. Let us see the technique of this asana. Lie flat on the back on a soft blanket. Keeping the legs stretched, place both the hands by the side of the trunk, palms touching the ground. Take a few deep breaths. While inhaling, raise the left leg without bending the knee, pointing the toes up to an angle of 45 degrees. For a few seconds, be in the same posture and bring it down with exhalation. While inhaling, raise the right leg without bending at the knee, pointing the toes up to an angle of 45 degrees. For a few seconds, be in the same posture and bring it down with exhalation. Repeat the same movement with the right leg and the left leg. Repeat both the legs together. Raise your both legs. And bring them down with exhalation and relax. Let us move on to the next one, Savasana. It is also called Carp's posture. Let's see the benefits of this Carp's posture. This removes the fatigue caused by the other asanas and induces calmness of the mind. It is a relaxation posture. Now let's see the technique of this savasana. Lie flat on the back like a corpse. Keep the hands a little away from the thighs with the palms up. Place the feet apart such that both the heels face inwards and toes outwards. Face the feet apart such that both the heels face inward and toes outward. Relax the body completely, part by part, with awareness of the breath and closed eyes. Be in that posture for some time and relax. And after some time, come back to Samasthiti and relax. Let us go for the next one, Salabhasana. It is also called locust posture. Let us see the benefits of this locust posture. This posture relieves pain in the knees and hips. It cures constipation. Lie full length on the floor on the stomach with the chin touching the ground on soft blanket. Keep the hands by the side of the trunk such that the palms touch the ground. Raise the left leg with inhalation. And do not bend the knees, stretch the toes. For a few seconds, be in the same posture and bring it down with exhalation. When you raise the right leg with inhalation, without bending at the knee, stretching the toes, and after a few seconds, please bring it down with exhalation. Let us move on to the next posture. Uttana Padasana. It's also called raised leg posture. Let us see the benefits of this raised leg posture. It reduces the fat in the areas of hips, thighs and torso. It cures all the diseases pertaining to urinary system, piles and fistula. Let us see the technique of this asana. Lie flat on the back on a soft blanket. Keeping the legs stretched, place both the hands by the side of the trunk, palms touching the ground. Take a few deep breaths. While inhaling, raise the left leg without bending the knee, pointing the toes up to an angle of 45 degrees. For a few seconds, be in the same posture and bring it down with exhalation. While inhaling, raise the right leg without bending at the knee, pointing the toes up to an angle of 45 degrees. For a few seconds, be in the same posture and bring it down with exhalation. Repeat the same movement with the right leg and the left leg. Repeat both the legs together. Raise your both legs. and bring them down with exhalation and relax. Let us move on to the next one, Savasana. It is also called Carp's Posture. Let's see the benefits of this Carp's Posture. This removes the fatigue caused by the other asanas and induces calmness of the mind. It is a relaxation posture. Now let's see the technique of this Savasana. Lie flat on the back like a corpse. Keep the hands a little away from the thighs with the palms up. Place the feet apart such that both the heels face inwards and toes outwards. Relax the body completely, part by part, with awareness of the breath and closed eyes. Be in that posture for some time and relax. And after some time, come back to Samasthiti and relax. Let us go for the next one, Salabhasana. It is also called locust posture. Let us see the benefits of this locust posture. This posture relieves pain in the knees and hips. It cures constipation. Lie full length on the floor on the stomach with the chin touching the ground on soft blanket. Keep the hands by the side of the trunk such that the palms touch the ground. Raise the left leg with inhalation. And do not bend the knees, stretch the toes. For a few seconds, be in the same posture and bring it down with exhalation. When you raise the right leg with inhalation, without bending at the knee, stretching the toes, and after a few seconds, please bring it down with exhalation. Please stand up. Now we switch over to Tadasana, Samasthiti. Now let's look at the technique of Tadasana. Raise your hands slowly above your head and interlock your fingers, turning your palms upwards. And inhale, raise your body slowly on your toes. Now exhale, raise your body downwards, touching ground with your feet. Repeat this 3 times. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Slowly inhale. Exhale. Hands down. And relax. Let's start Tiryak Tadasana. Let's see the technique in Tiryak Tadasana. Raise your hands above your head and interlock your fingers, turning your palm upwards, and exhale and turn your body to your right side. Now breathe in and come to natural position. Now exhale and then turn your body slowly to your left side and breathe in. Now come to natural position. Repeat this for 3 times. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Put your hands down slowly. Now relax. Now let's switch over to Parshva Tadasana. Let's look at the technique in Parshva Tadasana. Raise your hands slowly above your head and interlock your fingers, turning your palm upwards, and inhale, exhale. Slowly bend your body to your right side. Now inhale and come to the natural position. Now exhale, bend your body to your left side, inhale and come to the natural position. Repeat it for 3 times. Exhale, slowly, inhale, exhale. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, put your hands down slowly and relax. Now let's switch over to Udarakarasana. Let's see the techniques in this posture. First, stretch your arms forward up to shoulder level. Exhale, turn your body to the right side slowly, touching right shoulder with left hand. Inhale and come to normal position. Now exhale, turn your body to the left side, touching left shoulder with the right hand. Inhale, come to the normal position. Repeat this 3 times. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Surya Namaskar or Sun Salutation is a sequence of 12 powerful yoga poses. Now stand erect. Keep your feet together. Let us repeat all the steps one by one. Step 1, Pranamasana. Step 2, Hasta Uttasana. Step 3, Pada Hastasana. Step 4, Ashva Sanchalanasana. Step 5, Dandasana. Step 6, Ashtanga Namaskara. Step 7, Bhujangasana. Step 8, Parvatasana. Step 9, Ashva Sanchalanasana. Step 10, Pada Hastasana. Step 11, Hasta Uttasana. Pranamasana. Relax. Raise your hands up. Bring your hands down. Now, let us repeat all the steps one more time. Step 1, Pranamasana. Step 2, Hasta Uttasana. Step 3, Pada Hastasana. Step 4, Ashva Sanchalanasana. Step 5, Dandasana. Step 6, Ashtanga Namaskara. Step 7, Bhujangasana. Step 8, Parvatasana.
స్టెప్ 9 అశ్వసంచలనాసనం. స్టెప్ 10 పాదహస్తాసనం. స్టెప్ 11 హస్త ఉత్తాసనం. స్టెప్ 12 ప్రణామాసనం. Now relax. Raise your hands up. Slowly bring them down. Now slowly breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Now let us repeat all the steps one by one. Step 1, pranamasana. Step 2, hasta uttasana. Step 3, పాదహస్తాసనం. స్టెప్ 4 అశ్వసంచలనాసనం. స్టెప్ 5 దండాసనం. స్టెప్ 6 అష్టాంగ నమస్కారం. స్టెప్ 7 భుజంగాసనం. Step 8, Parvatasana. Step 9, Ashvasanchalanasana. Step 10, Padahastasana. Step 11, Hastavuttasana. Step 12, Pranamasana. Now relax, raise your hands up, bring them down, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Now Savasana. Now slowly lie down on your back. Leave some space between both the legs. Stretch your hands a little. Now slowly inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now samasthiti. Bring your both legs together, hands together. Slowly get up and sit. Kapalabhati is also known as Kal Shining Breath, Kapala means skull and Bhati means light. The emphasis is on the exhalation through strong, fast abdominal contractions, and so has a cleansing effect on the breathing pathways. Now let us see the benefits of this Kapalabhati. It improves circulation, especially to the brain, which gives the skull shining effect, energizing the mind and waking up your system. Kapalabhati also creates heat and increases and stimulates the digestive fire, which is also called Agni, by strengthening, massaging and toning the abdominal muscles and digestive system. Let us see the Kapalabhati technique. The inhale follows naturally after the strong exhale. Relax. Now slowly inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now let us repeat this Kapalabhati one more time. The inhale follows naturally after the strong exhale. Relax. Slowly inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now let us see the meaning of Surya Bhedana. In yogic terminology, the right nostril referred to the gateway of sun energy or Pingala Nadi, and left nostril is gateway of moon energy or Ida Nadi. Sun energy is the representation of heart or masculine vitality in the body, while moon energy represents calmness or feminine vitality. If we go by the literal meaning of Surya Bhedana, Surya means sun, Bhedana means piercing or entering. Surya Bhedana Pranayama is the deep inhalation of breath through the right nostril, then holding the breath for as long as comfortable, and finally exhaling through the left nostril. Now sit in any comfortable position, but sit erect. Form Prana Mudra with your right hand. When you close your right nostril, use your right thumb. When you close your left nostril, use your right finger, ring finger and little finger. If the deep inhalation of breath through the right nostril, then holding the breath for as long as comfortable, and finally exhaling through the left nostril. Let us do it. Inhale through right nostril, hold it for some time, exhale it through left nostril. Now repeat this. Inhale through right nostril, hold it for some time, exhale through left nostril. Inhale. Exhale.
Hold.
Hold. Exhale. Inhale. Inhale. Hold. Exhale. Inhale. Hold. Exhale. Inhale. Hold. Exhale. Inhale. Hold. Exhale. Relax.
Let us move on to the next one, Bhramari Pranayama. It is also known as humming bee breath. Let us see the benefits of this posture. Bhramari relieves stress and cerebral tension. It also helps elevating anger, anxiety, and insomnia. Now, sit in a comfortable meditation asana. Close the eyes and relax the whole body for a short time. Put your index fingers in both of your ears and start listening to the humming sound within your body. The humming sound should be smooth, even, and continuous for the duration of the exhalation.
Relax.
Start Swasti prayer.
Swasti bhavatu. Om sarvesham shanti bhavatu. Om sarvesham purnam bhavatu. Om shanti shanti shanti. Hari Om tatsa. Om namah.
Thank you.